The next device I want to look at is a device called a bridge. Bridges were used to take a large network and break it into smaller segments. If you remember previously, I told you if you put too many computers on a segment, then those computers would begin creating so many collisions that you couldn't send data through the segment. Well, bridges were a device intended to minimize that or put a stop to it. The way the bridge would do that is you would take the large segment with a lot of devices, you place the bridge in the middle of that segment, thereby effectively creating two smaller segments with half the number of computers on them. The result would be fewer collisions and better ability to get the packets through the network communications link. Bridges are an older technology, but they are relevant to talk about because the bridges are the forerunner to the modern switches that we use today. The bridge, just like the switch, works on the layer 2 of the OSI model. What makes the bridge have the ability to separate a segment into two smaller segments is the fact that the bridge can read the frames that come into it, and by looking at the address in the frame, it can determine whether a frame is allowed to pass through the segment or should be blocked because it's coming from a location that already has that address on it. In this way, bridges are able to reduce the amount of traffic on a network by dividing it up into multiple segments.